Good morning everyone. So today we will conduct one more experiment. We will see how exactly the connections are made to do this speed control of a three-phase slip ring induction motor by rotor resistance control method. This is one more experiment in our electrical machine lab 1. So the main aim of the experiment is to demonstrate that the speed control of a three-phase slip ring induction motor can be achieved by rotor resistance control. So this is the overall circuit diagram which we use to do this experiment, speed control of a slip ring induction motor. Of course, we'll be having a three-phase supply and it should be given to the auto transformer. From auto transformer, the supply is given to R by B terminals of the stator. It is a star connected slip ring induction motor. So we need to, if you want to know the current which is drawn by the phase of a star connected a three-phase induction motor, we can connect an ammeter here. Again, this voltmeter shows the line voltage applied to the stator terminals of a three-phase slip ring induction motor. Again, the rotor is connected, the R by B phases of the rotor are connected to the R by B phases of a external stator rotor resistance. We will be having a interconnected rheostat there, so we can connect that R by B phases to that. So this is the overall setup what we use to do the speed control of a three-phase slip ring induction motor with 5 HP and 3.7 kilowatt. And this is the external resistance what we use to do this external resistance, so which is connected to rotor terminal. So here also we will be having mains, three-phase supply and the auto transformer. Here also the similar manner we have to connect the auto transformer, how exactly we have connected it for load test and no load and lock rotor test. So input terminals we have from mains, the connections are given to, the supply is given to auto transformer first from R by B. Here also we can use the respective coloring wires to do the connection. So R by B should be given to, so input terminal R by B of a auto transformer, then the output terminal of the auto transformer, three-phase auto transformer R by B are taken out, and those connections are given to the multimeter here, where exactly we can see the voltage, phase line voltages and line currents by using this multimeter. And this output of a multimeter should be given to the stator terminal. It is a star connected stator terminal. Just by seeing the diagram we can understand that it is star connected. Again, the star connected rotor 3 R by B terminal should be connected to the external resistance box R to R1 terminal, then the second terminal Y to R2 terminal, then B terminal should be given to R3. So we will be having a knob here. By just rotating this knob, so we can adjust the 75%, 50% and 0% of the resistance from this resistance box, which is called as a external resistance, which is added to the rotor circuit here. This is how exactly the connections goes for a three-phase slip ring induction motor to control its speed. Now let's see how exactly the conduction goes. As per this circuit diagram, the overall setup is made. The three-phase slip ring induction motor used for this experiment is having a rating of 5 HP and 415 volt. We have used a three-phase auto transformer to give rated voltage to the stator. Again, we have used a resistance box, a variable resistance box, by which we can vary the resistance which is given to the rotor in steps of 100%, 75%, 50% and 0%. Initially, the winding is kept at starting, which indicates that 100% resistance is included for the rotor side. Before starting the experiment, we should confirm that the three-phase auto transformer should be kept at zero position. After confirming the zero position of the auto transformer, switch on the three-phase supply. And keep the multimeter in voltage mode. Now vary the three-phase auto transformer gradually and apply the rated voltage of 415 volt. By looking into the multimeter, we can apply a rated voltage for the stator. Slowly vary the auto transformer till the rated voltage is applied. Around 415 volt is applied to the stator terminals. Now, as we have applied 100% resistance, the speed of the three-phase induction motor is less. It is around 1220 RPM, which can be observed in the RPM meter. Now, the rotor resistance is reduced back to 75%. Means 75% of the resistance is added for the rotor circuit. Now, the speed has been increased to 1320. We have to note down the readings for cut-in percentage, that is 100%, 75%, 50% and 0%, and corresponding RPM of the motor. Now, next, put the knob to 50% of the resistance. Still, the speed has been increased. It is around 1395 RPM. Next, increase it and keep the rotor rheostat to zero position. Means zero resistance is included for the rotor side. Now, the motor is rotating at its rated speed of 1500 RPM. It's showing 1497. So, by keeping a resistance in the rotor circuit, we can vary the speed of a three-phase slip ring induction motor. Again, bring back the resistance to 50, 75, and by keeping the rheostat box to 100% resistance, the auto transformer is brought back to zero position. Gradually reduce the applied rated voltage back to zero. Then switch off the main supply. The graph RPM versus percentage cut-in resistance is plotted, and the nature of graph which will be obtaining is as shown in the video. So, this is all about speed control of a three-phase slip ring induction motor.